Hey guys, we're going to do today's mobility. We're going to start 1 minute at the bottom of our squat. We're going to do two rotations. We're going to open up our hip flexors, we're going to hit our calves, and we're going to do a couple of upper body stretches, so open up the chest and the shoulders from last night. So you can hit this before or after, it doesn't really matter. Obviously after, I always do mobility before, before we can do the workout. If you're pretty new, that's like it's injured. We're going to do spend a minute at the bottom of the squat. Some of you might feel a little bit sore just from doing mobility. When we're stretching out those muscles and they become so tight. We don't want to overstretch. We don't really want that soreness. We want to push our stretch to this point of discomfort, no further. Keep those knees out. Work on that squat position. So if you do struggle with those squats, you struggle with that squat mobility, film yourself, send it to me, we'll chat about it, and we'll see what we can do. Obviously, you can see my mind, we just get back to it, I'm a bit lazy on my mobility. I keep that balance in my foot. Down, just nice, slow and controlled. If you only get to here, you only get to here. You want that elbow touching, you go for the mid foot. Bring my hand in. Just too far out. Feel those hamstrings. Last time, we're going to open up the chest here. Try and feel that. Or the thoracic spine might be a bit tight. Sharp so that you've done something. If you want, I would do it three times, or you're going to do it three times, but I don't want the video to be too long that you just skip out on it. We don't live in a perfect world, we all have loads of time to do mobility. We're going to get most bang for our buck, and I'm going to actually do it, so that's why we're going to keep the video short and sharp. go too high, we take it away from the chest. I've got a little bit of impingement on the shoulder. Be 16 minutes today. Change your arms. Lift that hand up. I'm going to turn in. You're going to feel that stretch across your pec. So come to a position where you feel the stretch. We're going to put in discomfort. You're going to push it a little bit. Not too much. From the calf of the shoulders, usually you get shoulder niggles, chest too tight, or back's too tight, or biceps too tight. Your shoulders are almost fucking vulnerable, so sometimes you do get, will get shoulder injury eventually, but at some point in your life, you get niggled. Right, and you're going to work around and identify why. Right, you go straight to, I'm injured because of my shoulders. They don't say, oh, is my shoulder injured because my chest is too tight, my back's too tight, why is my movement doing? Okay, so, take into the long grip, and we're just going to dead hand. Let our head come through, draw our knees to grappling, and that's fine. We are in an underarm grip today. Don't have a pull-up bar going for the bar one. If you need to take breaks, just hop down and then come back up. Every day we're going to aim to make that squat just a little bit better. As you see, my toes still turn out, but those hips are tight. We're going to work on those hips tomorrow. Which one is that? I'm going to make sure that I'm balanced because my knees turn in, and I know why. It's because I'm hopping to the inside of my foot. Tight ankles. Sit that bum back, just make sure that I'm in a good position. Chest up. Send it to me. Side on, front on. We'll work it out together. And here, more mobile. Mobile half up now. Watch the American tilt. Do that. Recover quicker. Move better. A bit faster. Miss power movements of our cleans and our snatches. Moving. comfortable with you. So I'm not flagging you. lies, but not ideal well. As long as you're hanging, you've got the chest and the shoulders, build that glute at the same time. And relax. Well done, guys. It's another day done.